Many tales exist in Tale World, and this one is my very favorite. The kingdoms of Gellum and Igni had been at war since time immemorial. One day, the king of Igni brought his young sons, Ashbringer and Hark, to lead troops into battle. The young princes were unstoppable. Together, they crushed their opposition and reached the capital of Gellum. Their troops prepared to deliver a final blow. But then, in the midst of battle, Ashbringer saw her. The young princess of Gellum stood on the walls of the fort. She was brave. She was beautiful. She stole his heart. Against all reason, with victory at their fingertips, Ashbringer dropped his sword. "I cannot fight such beauty, my lady," he said. "I surrender to you." She accepted his surrender and his heart. And for once, war was replaced by love. Peace came to the land. We thought that peace would last forever.
"Your Majesty, come quick. It's your husband. He's dying." "I found him like this. I can't explain it, my lady.
Please step aside, Hark. I need to see him."
"A strange illness has taken hold of me. I'm turning to crystal inch by inch."
"What? But how? What is—"
"I don't know. But I fear I don't have much time left before I'm completely gone. My only hope lies with the Healing Scepter. The Wind Baroness has it."
"My aunt? Of course. I'll go get it for you right away."
"This is no task for a queen, brother. It's too dangerous. I'll go instead."
"My queen is as strong as she is beautiful, Hark. She will be the one to retrieve the scepter. But you can go with her to the Wind Barony. Serve her as you would me."
I will do as you ask, my lord."
"Prepare yourself, darling, and let me—" "With you, darling. I can't go with you, but I can give you something to help. The Ring of Fire has many abilities. It will protect you from flames and let you bend them to your will."
"I'll scout ahead and wait for you on the other side, Your Majesty."
There's a figurine in the flames, but I don't know how to get it.
We were born aflames, my lady. Your ring can make you one with them. No fire will harm you.
Thank you. Thank you.